December, we welcome you to Raleigh at PNC Arena. We move through the early stages of the Atlantic Coast Conference, and this afternoon, the third meeting all time between NC State and South Carolina State. And with Mike Jaminski, West Durham, we welcome you to our coverage. And G-Man, at 6-2, Kevin Keats has made a very early, very strong impression on the Wolfpack.
Well, they had a summer trip to Italy, which got things going. Then a nice trip down with the Battle of Atlantis, a terrific win over Arizona. Bounced back with a win against Penn State. And changing the culture here, they want to play up-tempo offensively and turn you over defensively.
Well, and one of the guys who showed up big in the win over the Nittany Lions the other night was the sophomore from Turkey, Omer Yurtseven.
You know, they've been bringing him off the bench, Wes. He got into some foul trouble early in the year. He's still playing starter minutes, 6 of 7 from three on the year, and he's been terrific.
Well, he hit three big threes the other night in the comeback against Penn State. Now for South Carolina State, Murray Garvin's team picked up their first win the other night, but they're relying on a transfer, and that's Dante Wright, who had 24 at UCLA.
6 of 11 from three in that game, so a dangerous player there. They should be playing with a lot of confidence. They've had a rough early schedule, but they're coming off a win.
Bulldogs and Wolfpack from Raleigh start a busy day of ACC basketball headed into the championship football game tonight. We're back with our first half right after this. Well, we get your ACC basketball Saturday started here in Raleigh. Bulldogs of South Carolina State are in to meet the Wolfpack, and here's Kevin Keats's lineup that features a heavy three-guard lineman, Mike.
Well, and that's what he's comfortable playing with. They're able to create some havoc out on the outside. And Leonard Freeman of this group is their primary inside player.
Yep, and South Carolina State gets Dante Wright, who we told you about in the open. James Richardson had 23 in their win over Morris on Tuesday night. Torin Dorn is a sophomore on this roster who's played 30 minutes the other night and had a dozen rebounds. And there is Braxton Beverly, who for NC State and for ACC fans has been given the opportunity to be a part of this team, where the NCAA reversed an earlier ruling about one summer school class he took at Ohio State before he elected to transfer.
Well, reversed, maybe not the right word. Getting it right, yeah, I think, is the correct phrase. I mean, it should have never been an issue, just penalizing a kid for actually going to class.
Yeah, amazing. Here is Beverly. And Markel Johnson on the attack, and the triple to start us. Braxton Beverly, 6-3 of the year in the Wolfpack. Presses.
Well, Kevin Keats was worried of, concerned. This is the first noon start that this team has had, so he wanted to see how they came out and energized, picking up defensively, but certainly that three, a great start.
Ty Johnson's a redshirt senior for these Bulldogs from South Carolina State, and here is Richardson. The shot clock at 10. James Richardson spots up and going the rebound.
The team in South Carolina State gave UCLA all they wanted.
And there's the grad transfer from Baylor, Al Freeman's first basket.
Now, we've talked in the open about how they want to play up-tempo offensively, and that was a very quick transition from defense to offense off the rebound.
And the two off from right. Here's Dorn. All the way through, and Freeman, and one. Well done on the ball handling in here by NC State to stay with the transition piece, Mike.
No, and that's, the look, you get the transition. Dorn hasn't been scoring well lately, but that breaks down the defense and allows Freeman to get inside. We talked about, they're going to come off the bench with Yurtseven, their biggest player, but Freeman, after he's finally healthy for the first time in a couple of years, Wes.
No question, free throw good. 82% coming in, leads the Wolfpack, who is 70.3 as a squad. And State pitching a shutout here in the first minute and a half in Raleigh. Damian Applewhite. In the corner is Dante Wright's three. Beverly looking ahead, Freeman. And wanted to go to Freeman, who had not gone all the way down into the corner. So a turnover for the Wolfpack. And our First chance to visit in Link with the new Wolfpack coach, Kevin Keats, at 45 years of age. And we've got to be impressed, Mike, with the early work he and his staff have done here.
No, it's been like, he talked about that trip to Italy in the summer really helped things. Usually that trip was supposed to happen last year because of terrorist alerts, it was canceled. So usually a first-year coach doesn't get that sort of thing, but plenty of time to, work with them. They've had a lot of practice time together. And, the one thing that Kevin Keats has said is that right from the start, he's been very impressed with this team's effort on the floor, whether practice or a game.
Solomon. And Freeman, the rebound.
I don't think you're going to have many South Carolina State players on the offensive glass.
Catch and score by Freeman. Great look by Braxton Beverly at the top here.
Yeah, they'll play with five guys out on the perimeter, and that really opens up bounce passes and cuts to the lane. There you see the nice screen and beautiful, because the spacing was so good, there's no time for the defense to help. And love the bounce pass in that situation, Wes. Just throw it beneath all the hands defensively.
And Lennard Freeman's second chance at an and one. 10-0 lead for the Pack. Ian Kennard has come on the floor for the first time for South Carolina State during that break. He wears number 24. Solomon tried to kick it back, and Damani Applewhite couldn't handle it. Now NC State buys in, and a held ball is going to go to the Bulldogs, and that's going to be a win for South Carolina State because the shot clock was at two.
And, that's an instance where good defense almost, you get penalized for it.
Yeah. Murray Garvin now in season six in Orangeburg. Bulldogs are kind of in the middle of the MEAC standings in the preseason and have played up the scale in terms of the early schedule. Out to UCLA, they've played at Boston College, they've played at Clemson.
This is a league where the big dog last few years has been right down the road in Durham and North Carolina Central.
Shot clock violation will give NC State the quick turnover. Yeah, Lavelle Moten has done a marvelous job at NC Central, Mike.
We were here 4 years ago when they came into this building and won in overtime.
Yep. State 4-for-4 from the floor. And Torin Dorn went baseline, but stepped out of bounds. Second turnover in as many possessions for the Wolfpack. Now, Kevin Keats' teams at North Carolina Wilmington were 72-28 under his guidance, and they went to postseason all 3 years. One NIT berth and two NCAA trips. That brand of basketball revitalized the Seahawks, and it's off to a fantastic early start here in Raleigh.
Yeah, that's the good news, bad news in a program like that. You get a coach like Kevin Keats, and you don't get to keep him. He does such a great job, he moves up to the next level.
Beverly three. Rich seven. Recover. Too strong on the stick back in the third try, and a foul ticketed to the South Carolina State Bulldogs. And this break on the personal gives us a chance to look at Mike Jeminski's four keys to the game today, G-Man.
Well, we talked about with the Bulldogs and South Carolina State having to try to handle the pressure that NC State's going to throw at them, especially full court. And for the Wolfpack, create early energy. The noon game, crowd kind of slowly getting into it, and they certainly have done that in the first 3.5 minutes.
Raynor Powell has come into the ball game for South Carolina State for the first time, and likewise, so is Sam Hunt for NC State as Al Freeman gets his second field goal here.
This is almost the reverse of the Penn State game where the Penn State got off to an 11-0 start and the Wolfpack had to fight back in it.
Applewhite and a whistle and foul on Kennard. It'll be his second. Four now on the Bulldogs.
And it's hard. The Bulldogs have gotten no easy baskets in this game. They've all been contested jump shots. They need a mental health basket at this point just to see the ball go through the hoop.
South Carolina State's 0-for-7 from the floor. Dorn in the corner. This is what Hunt does. Sam Hunt's 13th three of the year. Coming in, Mike, 85% of his field goal attempts were threes. Raynor Powell will feed Kennard. He'll get the first basket of the ball game for the Bulldogs and a foul.
Well, on the one end, you had Sam Hunt. We talked about 11-0 start that Penn State had. He was the guy who came off the bench and bailed them out early in that first half. Beautiful stroke right there. But then down the other end, it was really the first easy basket that the Bulldogs had. So I think going into the first media timeout, to see some points on the board gives them a little bit of a lift.
Ian Kennard from Clinton, South Carolina. The free throw good. He's 74%. He had a double-double in their loss to Central Arkansas. And more substitutions. David Bottenberg, a sophomore from Rockville, Maryland, onto the floor for South Carolina State. Murray Garvin getting into his bench against the pressure offered up by NC State here early. Rayshon Neal's onto the floor for the first time for the Bulldogs. Here's Sam Hunt, other corner. Dorn, the rebound in traffic. Back strong and gets the basket. First points for Torin Dorn Jr.
Really had a great start to the season offensively. First four games, has struggled the last four. But the one thing that's been consistent with him, Wes, is his rebounding. Doing a nice job on the glass.
Neal. Chennai Raynor Powell can't find an alley on the baseline. Drive by Rayshon Neal, freshman from Legacy Charter in Greenville, South Carolina. Gets him on the board for the first time.
It looks like starting now to feel a little bit better about themselves offensively. Nice drive that time.
State will change the tempo defensively on you quick, won't they? Beverly a three. Yes, sir. Braxton Beverly, a couple of threes. 6-7 on the year. We've been struggling to shoot it at home. Had the young man from Kentucky and almost got a play in the open floor there. Look at the timeout. First break in the action in Raleigh. All Wolfpack early. Leonard Freeman. A couple of and-one chances for Kevin Keats' Wolfpack.
ACC College Basketball is brought to you by your local Ford dealer and Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. The tools you want, you got it.
Man, so hard to believe. 35 years this April, Mike, to Jimmy V.
Amazing, and you know, so much this week to talk about raising the money for the V Foundation, which we strongly urge everybody to be involved with. But think about that era, Wes, those coaches that came in at the same time,
yep.
Krzyzewski, Valvano, Kremins,
yep.
And you know, Coach Smith was clearly at the top of the list, but those three went right after him early on.
Yep. The young guns, as Kremins will tell you.
Yep.
Your seven, the rebound of the Applewhite miss, Markel Johnson. Directs the Wolfpack offense. LeVar Batts Jr., a promising young prospect into the ball game, and a nice pass to Omer Yurtseven for his first hoop.
He's not really going to see any South Carolina State player that he gets in the post against. He's just going to, especially if he gets deep position like that.
This is what impresses you, I think, about NC State, Mike. Their ability to create problems just on entry passes defensively against the Bulldogs.
Well, you know, I think of Yurtseven more as a perimeter player, especially in the pick and roll game. But if he can start, you know, developing that, it really gives them some flexibility, especially when Abu comes back.
Yep. Lob hit the rim from Markel Johnson. Now transition opportunity, and Raynor Powell had it poked away by LeVar Batts. Well done by the young freshman Batts. From Concord, North Carolina, averaging about 15 minutes a game. And Torin Dorn gets a round of applause as Sean Kirk, junior from Whiteville, North Carolina, onto the floor for the first time for State.
He really hasn't. He hasn't played a lot this year. DMP, 6 out of the 8 games so far.
He's going to get an early opportunity here from Coach Keats. You see Al Freeman come back as well to replace Sam Hunt.
I think, you know, you look at this team, and we talked about Leonard Freeman and everything. I think Abu is going to be really key once they get into conference play. They're going to need his size and rebounding and shot blocking.
Neal. Applewhite. South Carolina State got a couple of baskets. Shot clock at 5, and Raynor Powell's jumper bounced away, and a foul on Sean Kirk, I believe. Les Jones, who works with Tim Comer and Bert Smith today. Foul on Kirk's his first, and that's number 2 on the Wolfpack. You mentioned Abdul Malik Abu, who came back and has played in 3 ball games. Did not play against Penn State, not playing here today. Almost turned over. Old Johnson is hurt.
And still, you know, it's amazing to me, and it went quickly over to the sideline, grabbing his knee.
So Markell Johnson shaking up on the play. And this play kid's pretty quiet. That did not. Let's have a look here, Mike.
It looked like he was battling for the ball, coming back out. It didn't look bad initially, but then you could see that he pulled up, but came down a little awkwardly on that play. And
I got him. DNC Arena, they'll tend to Markell Johnson. And we are going to take a break as well. So we'll step aside here at PNC Arena in Raleigh. NC State ahead early, almost 7 minutes in to this first half of play. You see Kevin Keats and Murray Garvin next to each other on the bench. Men who have, Murray Garvin's done a marvelous job with South Carolina State. And Kevin Keats is on a good start here at NC State. We welcome you. If you're just dialing here this afternoon on ACC basketball, NC State and South Carolina State played about 7 minutes of the first half, and a moment ago, on an inbounds pass, Markell Johnson's knee injury occurred, and as Johnson was being helped to the bench, and a medical incident occurred in front of the South Carolina State bench. We do not know for sure the player's identity. We do not know exactly what happened. The bench reacted accordingly. The players were around. Everybody's gotten very emotional here, and the EMS and the EMT folks here at PNC Arena and with NC State were out on the floor immediately trying to help this young man. And you can see Dante Wright there of the Bulldogs, who came in as their leading scorer. He's shaken. Most of these players have had tremendous emotion. And NC State has great concern. Thank you. But Murray Garvin is going to follow the EMS folks off the floor here, and South Carolina State is going to do the same, as is NC State. They've gone to their locker room, and Les Jones, the referee, talking with some of the athletic department officials here at NC State.
And South Carolina State, as a team, is going back to the locker room too, Wes.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your patience and understanding. The game is being delayed. We'll have more information for you in just a moment. Please remain in your seats.
Okay, we'll bring you back to Raleigh in just a moment, as the officials exit the floor here too. NC State in front. Back after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, the game will resume. Shortly, the teams will take the floor. We'll have a 10-minute warm-up and continue the game. We'll have an update on the player as soon as we get it.
So this ball game is going to resume, which is, and there'll be a 10-minute warm-up period for both the Wolfpack and the Bulldogs of South Carolina State. And so the game is going to continue, and NC State has come back out, and shortly I think South Carolina State will return as well from the locker room.
And I would you know, my sense would be, Wes, that was totally South Carolina State's call on that, you know, as far as to whether play or not, and a team and coaching decision.
Yep, I would agree with you on that, Mike. And I hope that that is encouraging news for the players.
That was my thought yep. too. That's again, we can't, and it's not right to speculate on what we don't know.
Right.
But you know, the hope is that is, as you said, encouraging news.
So we'll let you know what we find out about the young man, A, identity, and B, his condition. So while we're not being given the confirmation of identity of the player, we can tell you that the young man was responding.
Yeah.
Well, so that's awfully good news.
Yeah.
Awfully good news. So we'll come back to Raleigh. So at 12:50, we'll get the ball game back underway here in Raleigh. Well, NC State leads South Carolina State here. A ball game that'll be resumed somewhere about 10 till the hour is our guess, with Mike Chiminski, West Durham. You see NC State in front, but this ball game has been stopped because of a medical issue that occurred in front of the South Carolina State bench with 13:08 to play in this first half. With Mike Chiminski, West Durham, and we're going to get back to the ball game in a moment. A couple of housekeeping notes here. We do not have confirmed identity of who the player is, and therefore we're not going to release that until we have confirmed identity from the school, and they have elected not to tell us at this point. We do know that there is a report that the young man was responsive when he was taken from the arena. That's awfully good sign given the early stages of the moment.
Absolutely, and also he's on his way to the hospital, or if he hasn't already arrived at the hospital at this point. So that the most important part of this whole thing is being attended to as efficiently as it can be, and they were going to give both teams 10 minutes to come out, and now South Carolina State is coming back out from the locker room, getting incredible ovation from this team. And I don't know how this team emotionally can put it back together again and play this game. But certainly the crowd very appreciative. The NC State coaches clapping in unison as well, as are the players.
And so the Bulldogs, who saw NC State score the first 10 points and then fall behind by 17, have come back onto the floor. And Murray Garvin is a guy who, in six seasons at Orangeburg, has done a very nice job. The last couple of years have been a struggle. They were 7-9 in MEAC a season ago. But he is a guy of great positivity, Mike.
Yep.
In fact, does a lot of speaking in the offseason about positive day-to-day things that you go through in life, as well as the workplace and things like that. Speaks to a lot of civic groups in the upstate and throughout South Carolina. And so Coach Garvin and his team have, and I'm going to believe, without knowing for sure, that it was their decision to continue or not.
No, no question about it. And I thought if there was any doubt about it at all, that they would have not. And you know, the coaching staff I don't see Coach Garvin out at this point, but it was one of the most touching moments to see when all that was transpiring, was Kevin Keats going down to Moran, really having his arm around him, and you know, the fraternity of the coaching staff and the coaches in general, very, very close. And just looking at the South Carolina State players warming up, you know, they've got a positive look on their face, a sense of purpose. And you know, you don't want to trivialize what happened and say, all right, you know, they're going to come out and, but just showing the fortitude to be able to come out and play a game is incredible to me.
So we'll step aside here in Raleigh. Basketball resumption a few minutes away. So NC State leading South Carolina State 22-5. The ball game at 13:08 to go, and we're about 6 minutes and change from the Wolfpack and Bulldogs starting again. And this ball game was halted due to a medical incident involving a South Carolina State player in front of their bench after a coincidentally at the same time an injury occurred to Kevin Keats's guard, Markel Johnson. Which was just a knee or an ankle twist. And that's, again, speculation to a point. Johnson came off the floor, and he was getting attention where our eyes were focused, Mike,
right,
when then the issue in front of the South Carolina State bench took early and certainly proper precedent, and folks went to work very quickly.
Much, much less important, but no less. It looks like Markel Johnson, he's out warming up right now. But this was on an underneath out of bounds pass, Wes, and went up. He went up to grab it and came down awkwardly and then pulled up and didn't even wait for a stoppage of play because South Carolina State recovered the ball. He went over and limped to the sideline as quickly as he could and went down. And this, you know.
And there's the moment you were speaking of a moment ago.
Yeah, just incredible emotion, obviously, for Murray Garvin, but for Kevin Keats to go down there and be a part of that huddle and pick his coaching brethren up and try to console him as well.
So we are here in PNC Arena, and the NC State players, like the South Carolina State players, were in prayer for the young man in front of the Bulldogs bench. Now both teams have come back out on the floor, and the ball game here in about 5 minutes will resume with NC State in front. We can only hope that the decision by South Carolina State to continue play is good news in terms of the young man, who, as we understood, early reports were responsive as he left the floor and headed to one of the hospitals, which, by the way, are in the immediate area here around the PNC Arena location off the fairgrounds in Raleigh at the State Fair. And so hopefully that means that things are on the up and up for the young man. So we'll find out as much as we can. And as we said a moment ago, we'll let you know who the player is and something more official when we get some confirmation on it in just a moment. But
I say it certainly is as surreal an event as I've been a part of, Wes, in all the games that I've done. And yeah, I this goes not just for, not just for the South Carolina State Bulldogs, but, the NC State players were clearly shaken by this. And, so for both teams to engage again in this game, emotionally, mentally, physically, I think is going to be very difficult.
Yeah. And, well, in some ways, as we transition back to the playing of the game, Mike, we were kind of seeing in the first 7 minutes some of the staples of what Kevin Keats is building here. Pressure on both ends of the floor. And now you see Les Jones, the veteran official, lead Bert Smith and Tim Comer back to the floor. And we think we're going to play basketball here in just a few minutes.
I'm sure there were conversations with the leagues, maybe with the respective leagues that are involved here, and there you see the referees going up to the coaching staff for South Carolina State. I have not seen Murray Garvin back on the bench yet, so don't know, Wes, if, again, we can't confirm anything, but
right.
We don't know if he accompanied the young man to the hospital.
Correct.
And his staff is going to remain here to take over the coaching duties for the rest of this game.
Right. But here in about 2.5 minutes or so, we're going to resume basketball. On a busy Saturday in the ACC, this is one of 8 ball games involving conference teams, including a couple of others that are being started within the half hour. So, and NC State is here after a win on Wednesday night against Penn State in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, and South Carolina State came to Raleigh off their first win on Tuesday night against Morris College of South Carolina and the NAIA ranks.
Touched on it too, and as a lot of schools in this situation, South Carolina State has had a very daunting early part of their non-conference schedule. Most of their games coming up to the conference play are going to be on the road. They played at Wisconsin, at BC, at Yale, at UCLA, at Winthrop.
Well, we have been told that Murray Garvin did accompany the player to the hospital, so Rio Pitt, his top assistant, with Trevor Deloach and Sean Taylor on that staff. So Coach Pitt will be in charge of the Bulldogs here, and that is Coach Pitt to the right there in the blue suit. Coach Pitt is in the golf shirt. So both teams have gone around their benches.
I just talked to the assistant coach.
The latest report.
He said that it is number 23. Confirmed that he is breathing on his own, and they're on the way to the hospital. Okay, but he said it was okay.
So, Kevin Keats and...
Ladies and gentlemen, update on the South Carolina State student-athlete. The young man was stabilized and conscious, but he was taken to a local hospital for further evaluation.
All right, so the crowd has just been told that the young man involved in the incident was stabilized and taken to a local hospital.
Yep. And
Takatayak, who is the longtime public address announcer here at PNC Arena, has done also a nice job of thanking the local EMS and EMT folks, Mike, who did a did yeoman's work for their efforts here. And the young man and Coach Garvin on the way to the hospital. And he has been stabilized, is the word. So, South Carolina State returns to the floor, as does NC State. And the issue that drew our eye when the incident occurred in front of the Bulldog bench was the injury to Markel Johnson, who appears okay and is back on the floor. That is good news for the Wolfpack as well. So we begin the ball game. It's resumption here with just better than 13 minutes to go, and Rayshon Neal. And he works with Justin Jones. David Bottenberg is out there. Raynor Powell, Janae Raynor Powell, also on the floor. And that's Justin Jones scoring for the first time.
And Jones, a player, not much time, you know, 15 minutes a game, and not known as a great shooter, Wes. Less than 30% from the floor. This is I would sense the rest of this game, you'll see a lot of zone from South Carolina State.
Bernard Freeman has got seven. That's his third field goal.
I really, you know, compliment the crowd here, though, for the ovation that they gave South Carolina State when they came back out from the locker room, and also when the coaching staff came out.
Damani Applewhite. And a whistle and foul in the midcourt area. Foul is on Torin Dorn. It's his first. Third on the pack. So NC State, who played a furious first seven ball games, now kind of Kevin Keats gets his group into a bit of a exam break schedule, but also a chance to do some valuable teaching. Here's a turnover. Beverly ahead. There's a lob that was short. And a whistle and foul coming up on the transition chance. And we'll take a break. Back to Raleigh. With Mike Jaminski, Wes Durham, we welcome you back to PNC Arena here in Raleigh. We had about a 40-minute delay, a medical incident on the South Carolina State bench. Stopped the ball game with 13:08 to play. And that is assistant coach Rio Pitt, because head coach Murray Garvin has joined his player at a local Raleigh hospital after the incident in front of the bench. Here's a turnover by NC State after the Bottenberg foul got us to break. And the Bulldogs take over on the turnover. This is Damani Applewhite's. His jumper banged away, and NC State's got Al Freeman, Leonard Freeman, Braxton Beverly, Torin Dorn, and Markel Johnson on the floor. And Al Freeman got stripped of it and last touched by the home team.
And, you know, we talked about turning over in West right now. That was the fourth turnover for NC State, and to their credit, South Carolina State has not turned the ball over against their pressure yet. They're just getting shots. They're just not making them at this point.
Rayshon Neal is a freshman from Greenville. Working against Beverly. Al Freeman knocked it away.
Very tough to put the ball on the deck multiple times against this Wolfpack defense.
South Carolina State, who will be in Clinton, South Carolina on Tuesday night to play Presbyterian before getting another home game at Orangeburg against Brevard. There's a three out of the corner. Long for Janai Raynor Powell. Beverly. Nice pass. Freeman had it stripped away. Good recovery defensively. Fifth turnover by NC State.
Neal getting a nice job in there reading that. It was a solid pass.
Rayshon Neal on the runner. Gets the roll. Second field goal for Neal, who came in averaging right around three. Had 8 points at Winthrop in an earlier season effort.
Well, very solidly built, Wes, and did a nice job of taking that, using that strength against Beverly on the drive.
Nine
first half points to Leonard Freeman on his fourth field goal.
And he's perfect in the evening so far, in the afternoon so far.
Almost turned over. It'll stay with the Bulldogs, and Omer Yurt 7 and Sam Hunter back for the Wolfpack. And here is Dante Wright, who is scoreless, the Bulldogs' leading scorer, back on the floor for South Carolina State.
Applewhite to put it in play. Raynor Powell breaking into the front court. He's a junior from Virginia Beach. Transfer from Denmark Tech Community College.
Just, you know, everybody but from NC State, oh, the hands always active defensively. Count deflections.
Justin Jones had a look from Carpenter on that one with the shot clock winding down, and then saved, but saved right to Hunt. Good effort by Azante Fields, who's checked in for the first time. NC State's assisted on 10 of their 11 field goals so far. Lob, your 7, the catch, and the layup. Like you said early in the ball game, though, that'll be candy today for Omer.
Yeah, and it's, well, the big thing for him, a lot of big guys will bring the ball down in that situation, yeah, involve the guards, but he kept it up high, turned around, a little bit like Kevin McHale in that aspect.
Drive by Applewhite, fell off the rim, the scramble inside, and Wright gets it to Raynor Powell. Dorn the rebound of that miss. Front court Dorn, nice Euro. Did he get away with it?
Nope. No.
Burke Smith.
That was 2 euros, Wes. You get away with 1 euro, but not 2.
Take me through the fundamentals here.
So here's the look again. We talked about it. You're keeping the ball up high. He gets the catch. See, he never brings it down. He just goes right back. A nice soft touch off the glass. You don't have to dunk to make the play. I mean, that's just a very easy, simple basketball play.
G-Man likes the big guys keeping it above their shoulder, don't you?
Who can't dunk?
But it is one of the coaching points that guys, how many times during the year do we hear coaches talk about that, right?
Yeah, a lot of guys will, they'll want to take a dribble to get themselves, their legs underneath them to go up for a dunk and a spectacular play, and that's a terrific three.
Yeah, right. Dante Wright on the board, his 23rd three of the year.
And, he's the guy that they really need to have come alive in this game. I mean, he's had some big numbers against big opponents.
Lavard Batts misses. Now the Bulldogs on the run. Raynor Powell tried to lob it ahead for Alex Taylor. And the Bulldogs turn it over in transition. Under 8, first half, and Raleigh continues in a moment. ACC College Hoops on a Saturday with Mike Chiminski, West Durham, NC State, a 16-point lead. And our Toyota Let's Go Places. How about Leonard Freeman from our nation's capital? He's going places in his senior campaign, isn't he?
Well, you know, Kevin Keats talked about him, that he's been a real leader on this team. And here's a guy who didn't play last year and has not been healthy in a while. But this is the first year that he's come out. And nice to see a redshirt senior finally get a chance to show what he can do out on the floor.
Sam Hunt, triple from the corner, short.
You know, like I said, I mean, that's going to be a nice rotation with the three of them when Abu comes back and he's ready to play. You can go a little bit smaller with Abu and Freeman. If you want, against some bigger front lines, you can put the three of them out there together.
Richardson, here is Neal trying to work through the baseline. Wayne Banks on the floor for the first time. And Batts, young freshman from the Concord, North Carolina area in transition.
Yeah, this is what up-tempo makes you do. You know, North Carolina, it takes guys off the offensive glass. But once you hit half court, you have to get turned around and identify players, or NC State will run it right up your back.
Three ball. Richardson, his 7th of the year. James had a 23-point game in their win the other night, first double-figure game of the year, and there's a step out-of-bounds violation on Hunt, and here's a look at LeVar Batten overdrive.
Yeah, made a big splash his first game out against VMI, 10 points, but showing a lot of resolve. Again, nobody for South Carolina State gets turned around. You've got to stop the advance of a basketball.
State's got 7 points off turnovers. Make it nine as Damani Applewhite scores. He's their leading rebounder. First points here today. He had 27 the other night.
It's, you know, you're seven.
And inside, you're at seven again. Three for three is Omer. You're at seven from the floor. He's got six, and the Bulldogs turn it over. Well, and NC State, Mike, is going to force you to play fast. You know, they're going to force your tempo a little bit. And if you're not comfortable at the top of the gearbox, you work yourself into unforced errors, don't you?
Well, and the thing, too, Wes, is that you cannot relax once you've gotten the ball over half court, because we've seen several plays with pursuit from behind that get deflections. So you always have to be conscious of not only what's in front of you, but what's coming up behind you.
Just ahead of 6 minutes to go. Beverly.
This is where I think, you know, your seven has done some work inside against a smaller team, but I think against bigger teams, you'll see him a lot in a pick and pop out on the perimeter. And showed can score with both hands inside. Nice lefty finish.
Yep. 8 points now in his fourth field goal. 17-point lead for NC State, and a foul on Batts. Hand check in the midcourt area.
Well, between Freeman and your seven, they've missed one shot combined in that game. And again, when you get real estate like that, game comes awfully easy against a smaller opponent,
right? You think once he gets into conference play, Omer, your seven becomes a tough matchup, though, doesn't he?
Yeah, and that's why, I think he's the guy of the three that you use out on the perimeter more in the pick and pop. Now, he can pick and roll, but we talked about 6 of 7 from three so far. Now, that's obviously not going to continue throughout the whole year, but it's going to be a shot that teams are going to have to respect.
Commits the foul there. You're at seven's first, fifth on the pack. And here is Applewhite, just a 56% free throw shooter. Left-hander's first one. Pulling it through. That's the guy who Murray Garvin was talking in the preseason. They want this to be one of the guys that makes the next step.
In his sophomore year from Fayetteville.
Great game against Morris.
Oh, no kidding.
27 and 10.
Yep.
12 of 13 from the field. Sean Kirk's come back on the floor, and the drive and missed by Freeman, cleaned up by your seven. He's got 10.
You know, that's the thing that's not happening because of their size and also having to get back in transition for South Carolina State. 7 of 23, but only, you know, 3 offensive rebounds.
Foul on Freeman, his first. 6 here. So Kevin Keats, his team, one shy of sending South Carolina State to the bonus. So Dante Wright. Here is Raynor Powell working against Beverly. Neal, little shot fake, and the basket. Rayshon Neal was 6.
Yeah, he's been fearless coming off the bench.
Beverly out front, rattles in the 3.
You know, I've watched some games of Beverly, and I thought, Wes, that he's had a tendency to over-dribble sometimes, but he's done a much better job in this game of being a catch-and-shoot player.
Hey, what, he's shooting well in this building. The home gym had not been to his liking early in his Wolfpack career, but he's warmed up here today at PNC Arena. Neal had it batted away, trying to go to Taylor, and good hustle by LeVar Batts, and it'll stay with the Pack with 4:29 to go. The interesting part, Beverly's going to be one of those guys, and watching some of the Penn State game the other night, he's going to be one of those guys you're going to be glad he's on your team and drive you crazy he's on the other team if you're pulling for the other guy.
No, huh? No question about it. And the thing that really, you know, looking at his stats, I mean, he was such an integral part of that win against Arizona and against Penn State. Those are the only games that he shot free throws in this year.
Yeah, he's only had 17 free throw attempts, but you're right, they've come in 2 games.
Yeah. And it's...
Freeman will tee it up. You're at 7, the rebound, and a foul inside on Bottenberg.
I don't know the correct phrasing to say this, but from when this game restarted, you know, both teams were just kind of going up and down, and you can certainly understand that emotionally.
Right.
But it's only within the last couple minutes that I think they're, you know, starting to get back and, you know, get back into the game.
Yeah.
Here is Beverly, three off the catch. Cleaned up Freeman. He lost it on the bounce. Put it on the floor, Mike. Here's Wright. And Reno Powell will score at the hoop, his first basket.
This is one of the first easy baskets, per se, that for South Carolina State. And you know, sometimes the teams that like to run don't like to be run on.
Sean Kirk, second time we've seen him on the floor. Fall away, hit the rim.
Boy, nice job by Raynor Powell, making him settle for that jump shot.
They'll score that. That popped off the glass by Kirk. That'll get us to a timeout. Kevin Keats thought it might have been clean. So did Kirk. Back after this. Well, 3.5 to go in the opening frame. NC State in front by 14 with Mike Jaminski, West Durham on a busy day of ACC college hoops. And, you know, this stoppage of play here for about 40 minutes occurred with 13 minutes to go when South Carolina State player went down in front of the bench. And the young man who suffered the medical issue was Tyvore Solomon, redshirt senior from Johns Island, who started the ball game. And he, because of the great response of the EMT and the EMS people who got to him very quickly, along with the great medical staffs here.
Well, I would also credit the trainer for South Carolina State, who was the first one to administer, you know, aid to him. And, you know, he was not in the game at the time, was on the bench, and was clear that the coaching staff was standing around him while that action was occurring.
And Murray Garvin, the head ball coach of the Bulldogs, is with Solomon at the Raleigh hospital that he was taken to. And Rio Pitts running the operation here for South Carolina State.
As you would expect, Murray Garvin, I think in that situation, virtually any head coach, obviously, when you see the flurry of activity that happened very quickly around the bench, you knew it was a very serious matter.
Foul at the state end of the floor is on Dwayne Banks, his first. So our prayers and good wishes for Ty Solomon's full recovery. He was responsive when he left the building here, is the report we got. And we hope nothing but the best for Ty. Freeman, second chance, fouled on the way up. Boy, Leonard Freeman now. We have referred to South Carolina State as undersized at some point, but I'm seeing things that Leonard Freeman just physically, Mike, could not do the last 2 years.
Well, and the thing is, even though, I mean, he looks bigger, Wes, he's lost 20 pounds, so there's, you know, he's remade his body, staying here over the summer, working, and he is much quicker off of his feet.
Two out of three at the line is Freeman.
And, you know, the thing about, and he had players down at UNC Wilmington. If you're a big and you can run the floor, you're going to score points and you're going to shoot a very high percentage in this offense.
Yeah, Kevin Keats had a player for the Seahawks, Deontay Kaycock, who shot 80% from the floor and had 84 dunks last year in the Colonial.
That's what, you know,
Malik. G-Man like.
Malik Abu was... Malik Abu was, that's one of the things that sold him on, you know, coming back here and playing. Says, hey, look, young man, if you run from me, you're going to score some points.
Speaking of running the floor, Sean Kirk.
No, not a decision. That was a 3-on-1 break. He had no help back. You got to pull the ball out and wait for some friendly jerseys.
Rashawn Neal can't finish. Freeman, another rebound. One practice session with Kevin Keats, and you understand what the word competitive means, because everything NC State does has some consequence to it. There's a turnover. And there's a scoop and score. Nicely done, J.J. Richardson. He's got five. Boy, South Carolina State's taking advantage. 10 turnovers by the Pack and 13 points off of them.
Yeah, well, and that's what's keeping them in this game. And that was just a very sloppy pass to the wing. It's
Freeman gets the field goal on the bounce pass here, but
yeah, that was just Markell Johnson making a careless pass and the terrific transition score of that play by Richardson. But this is where, then conversely, this is where NC State has ruled this game in the paint so far.
Mm-hmm. Freeman's got 13, chance to make it 14. He's already above his scoring average here in the first half. And that one rolls out, so he's 3 of 5 at the line. State, though, the 10 turnovers too shy of their game average, G-Man.
And that's a little surprising. Freeman, for his career, has been a poor free throw shooter, but 82% on the season coming in. So that's usually don't see that type of jump to your senior year.
Yep. Torin Dorn's back. Sean Kirk got a couple sequences off Coach Keats's bench. Point lead for State. Under two to go. Neil Applewhite. Second field goal for Damani Applewhite. He's got a half dozen.
Along with Wright, one of the guys who averages double figures on this game, so the capability to score.
Johnson all the way through. Nice kick back from Beverly. Markell Johnson, 7-3 of the year. First points today for the sophomore from Cleveland. There's the catch and shoot by Dante Wright. And now ahead, Dorn. Got to catch it. And tried to make the save. And at the other end, here's Rayshon Neal. Strong to the basket and draws the foul from LeVar Batts. That'll be his second, 7 on the Pack with under a minute to go. And coming up at the start of the second half, we'll be joined by NC State football coach Dave Doran, who signed a 5-year extension approved by the Board of Trustees yesterday. 8-4 campaign. Wins over Florida State and Louisville, of course. And they'll be awaiting a bowl destination following championship weekend here in college football.
Yep, 6-2 in conference.
Yep. So Rayshon Neal, who's got 4 field goals, now has his first free throw. 9 for Neal.
It's been in 13 minutes of play.
Yep,
so very efficient, gave them a nice lift off the bench. And he was the one, I think, more than any of them, West, when play resumed, he got things going.
Yep,
for them.
So 10 for Neal, freshman from Greenville. He had 8 points and 4 rebounds at Winthrop. He's got a new season high in his young South Carolina State career here in Raleigh in this first half. State leads 15 as we work in the final minute, though. Johnson. Nice ball movement. Hunt's left-handed 3. Freeman had a shot at the rebound. Out of there come the Bulldogs. Neal ahead for Richardson. Layup good. 7 for J.J. Richardson.
Throughout this stretch over the last 5 minutes of the game, South Carolina State's been able to get out and run, and not a great job of NC State identifying where guys are on the floor.
One shot to go here for State. They'll wind the clock down. Markell Johnson working against Neal. Johnson on the drive. Nice pass. Freeman the dunk. Well, been an impressive half for Leonard Freeman. And a timeout call for by South Carolina State with 1.7 left. Pretty good work by Markell.
Yeah, no, really breaking down the defense inside, and all you have to do is have your hands ready and catch and finish on that play. With a good look, and Leonard Freeman, perfect from the floor, 6 of 6. 15 points and only 10 minutes of action for him.
Yep. Well, you got to be encouraged. If you followed Leonard Freeman's journey as a Wolfpack player, you got to be happy for him, number one. But number two, the encouragement he can provide to some of these young guys that Kevin Keats going to put in the fire.
He's got a nice blend. I mean, they're new players, but you've got Sam Hunt, who's a grad student. You got Torin Dorn, who's a redshirt junior. Leonard Freeman, redshirt senior. Abu, a senior.
Johnson at the horn.
So he's got a nice mix of new faces but older players.
Teams will go to the locker room. NC State leads by 15, 48-33. Hardy's halftime report from Raleigh coming up. Welcome back to Raleigh in today's edition of the Hardy's Halftime Report. And at the break at PNC Arena, NC State leads South Carolina State by a score of 48-33. We told you this is one of eight ball games on the docket in today's Atlantic Coast Conference College Hoop schedule. And we've got another one for you. Coming up at 4 o'clock this afternoon, Tom Wormy, Damian Fishback will be at Joel Coliseum in Winston-Salem. See Danny Manning's Deacons against the Richmond Spiders. So the A-10 tangles with the ACC this afternoon. And, of course, that means Silver Spring, Maryland's Brian Crawford averaging 16 points and 4 assists for the Deacons, who've had some highs and lows early in this season. But Darrell Moore, Brian Crawford, and Coach Manning's club in a 4 o'clock game this afternoon against Chris Mooney's Spiders of Richmond. Here in Raleigh, Markell Johnson served up Leonard Freeman's last field goal for the half. State by 15.
ACC College Basketball is brought to you by Hardee's, home of the $5 All-Star Meals.
Well, here in Raleigh, NC State leads South Carolina State by 15. Welcome back to the Hardee's Halftime Report. And G-Man, we got a full taste of Leonard Freeman in the opening 20.
Yeah, in fairness, there are no rim protectors for South Carolina State, but Leonard Freeman owned the paint in the first half of that game, showing a variety of moves, the ability to put the ball on the floor, had some good penetration from his guards, just catch and finish, perfect 6 of 6, 3 of 5 from the line, and 15 points, 10 minutes, doesn't get much more efficient than that.
State survived, I say, 11 turnovers. Kevin Keats still won't like that, will he?
No, and it's, it's only 20 minutes to play yet, but, you know, to have a lead at halftime and still be able to blister the paint and the locker room walls is not a bad thing, but that's probably about the only bad thing that you could talk about.
Well, nice moment here at the break. The NC State football team helping the Toys for Tots with the Marines at the break. Dave Doran will join us coming up on the Hardee's Halftime Report.
Thank you, Seth.
ACC College Basketball is brought to you by Toyota. Visit your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places. And Husqvarna Automower. All-star lawns start with Automower. Seeing is believing at automower.us.
48-33, NC State at the break. Dave Doran will join us next here in Raleigh. The head coach of the Pack will come sit with Mike and I. You've been watching the Hardee's Halftime Report from Raleigh. Well, here at the break, we mentioned this a moment ago. Great moment. Toys for Tots with the NC State Athletic Department and the Marine Corps. Kyle Bambard, the Wolfpack specialist out first to greet these young people in a great moment for the holidays. Talk about having a great Christmas, huh? And there on the back rows, Dave Doran. Got a brand new 5-year contract yesterday, 8-4 overall, 6-2 in the ACC. And Coach Doran's good enough to spend some time here. Going to take some big-time football questions from Jaminski, by the way, before we're done here. Yeah. But congratulations to you and your team on a good season, and congratulations on your new deal.
Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Excited. Family's excited. Team's excited. Recruits, a lot of momentum right now, and it's a great place to be.
Yeah, well, you've got a big weekend with some prospective student-athletes here, right?
We do. We've got 13 kids here, some committed, some aren't. And, you know, it's fun to be able to bring in the bowl practice and then the basketball game and, you know, just show them all the different things that NC State has to offer.
Well, one of the things that has occurred is this building process you've done since taking the job in Raleigh. Obviously, you took a big step this year in some things, but it's kind of only the beginning for the vision I know you and I talked about several years ago.
It is, and, you know, to be able to have a 5-year deal and you know, recruit with a 5-year deal means a lot to these parents. You know, they want to know that I'm going to coach their sons and that my contract takes them through that time, and it allows us to continue to develop young men and know that we have a 5-year plan to do it.
Well, Coach Doran's going to stay here for a few minutes with us. And I know he'd like to be having a ball game tonight in Charlotte. But we'll get his thoughts on the ball game tonight as you see NC State go right back to work here, Mike. And boy, Kevin Keats has done a marvelous job since coming here. Any days?
Yeah, it's the first time I've been able to watch him live. You know, they're playing fast, and you see him playing aggressive here on the court. And just getting to know all these new faces. He's got a lot of new guys on the court.
And a turnover, and here's Markell Johnson. You're at seven. Will trail the break and get the handiwork for the dunk.
There you go.
Yeah, we talked about it, Wes, with the bigs being able to run the floor, and you know, both Freeman and the time you're at seven following the play up.
Yeah, as a football coach, you love seeing big guys run. You know, it's fun seeing big guys running to the ball. You know, that's one watching a 7-footer run court to court. And it's big time.
G-Man, I know we were talking. We were talking about Coach Dorn being with us, and there were a couple things I know you were interested in. Number one, the success in the ACC, right?
Dave, yeah, and you looked at, I mean, your first job, Northern Illinois, and after a short stint there, took this job. What was it like to talk to that team about leaving, and what was it about this job that was attractive to you?
You know, leaving a place that was special like Northern Illinois with a bunch of great young men, we won back-to-back championships. It was hard, you know, and I think if you invest the way that I do with my heart and soul into a program, it's hard to leave. If you do it the right way, it's really hard. And, you know, if I'd have leaving this place, I would have torn my family apart, you know. And we just built such great relationships here with the people in Raleigh and with the players on our team, and feel like our work isn't done yet here.
Yeah, you know, what brought that to mind is with Jimbo Fisher and all the, and this is kind of silly season, and they call it silly season in NASCAR with drivers. It's kind of that way with football coaches this time of the year.
Yeah, it's an unfortunate part of the business, you know. You see guys getting fired maybe that shouldn't get fired, and you see guys leaving programs, and it's just the nature of the beast, unfortunately.
State's got a couple turnovers, Freeman a three, and now the Wolfpack has a loose ball here. Dorn had it deflected.
My favorite player, by the way.
Torn Dorn?
Oh, yeah. It's a good last name. I mean, he could spell it a little. He could spell it a little better, you know what I mean? But it sounds right to me. It sounds right.
Richardson scores at the other end.
As broadcasters, we like those easy last names as well.
Yeah, his doesn't get as mispronounced as mine or misspelled as mine either. Yeah,
they had a lot of fun with mine when I came down here into the league for the first couple of years.
Yeah. Yeah, something about Jaminski and Krzyzewski, it was a tongue twister for these guys.
I can see that.
The staff continuity you've built here. Eli Drinkwitz, your OC, Dave Huxtable, your DC, all just the coaching staff continuity as a whole has been critical, hasn't it?
It's always, you know, for these young men, you want to develop players, and when they have the same voice, you know, the guys that know them and have been through the ups and downs with them, I think that trust gets built in. And those guys are great human beings. Dave Huxtable, what he does, you know, and Eli, the way that those guys handle their respective sides of the ball with their kids and get them to play hard and to work the way you want them to work and buy into a system. And it's not always what everyone wants. You know, they all want us to shut every team out and score 100 points. That's not reality. But they got coaches that are doing it the right way, working with these kids, and the kids respect them and trust them.
Well, Dave Dorn, the Wolfpack football coach, is with us. I want to ask you about a couple of those guys. One is the defensive player of the year in the ACC, and that's Bradley Chubb, who had a phenomenal year. And your quarterback had a great season, too, in Ryan Finley.
Yeah, both those guys, I know, love being here. Both of them have worked so hard, and I was in the weight room today, and Ryan was getting extra work in. And, you know, that's just what they are. They're a bunch of guys that love the game. Bradley said it last night. He won the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, and they asked him about what's changed. And he said, when you come to the Murphy Center now, it's like a cocktail party. Everybody's hanging out, having a good time, watching film. And it's just a great culture to coach in, and it's taken time to build it that way. And it's fun to come to work right now with these young men.
Can't you be torn as a head coach, though, when your coordinators, you know, the better they are, the more opportunities, the offers they're going to get as head coaches. And it's got to be a fine line you walk between keeping that staff together and not wanting the best opportunity for these guys.
Well, if any of them become head coaches, I'm going to be really happy for them. You know, I think every assistant coach has that in their mindset at some point in time. And, you know, that to me is a tribute to what we do. It says that we do a good job. It says that I do a good job. It says that our football players are doing a good job. So, you know, if Eli or any of these coaches have that opportunity, I'm not going to be upset for them. I mean, they don't come hire offensive coordinators to be head coaches if you're not playing good on offense, you know what I mean?
Yep.
So if that happens for them someday, you know, we'll all be happy. And, you know, I got to keep a good list all the time of coaches in case things like that do.
Your thoughts on the championship game tonight. Yeah. How do you preview that and see that playing out?
Well, you got two really aggressive defenses, you know, both sides of the ball that play a lot of pressure coverages and bring different looks. And I think that's going to be the name of the game, who can be the most disruptive on defense. And, you know, conversely, who can do the better job of picking up those blitzes and not letting mayhem happen and fumbles and interceptions. And because that's what's going to happen tonight. Somebody's going to lose the game. You know, somebody's going to turn the ball over or make a huge mistake on special teams.
Inside goes Dorn for the hoop here. Dave, I want to ask you real quick. You went 6-2 in this league. You know how good this league has gotten in your tenure. You're part of that coaching revolution in ACC football. I know you're excited to have an opportunity to go to the postseason, too.
We are. You know, I know I've coached in the toughest league in college football for the last 5 years. And whether it's a national champion or a Heisman Trophy winner, I mean, we play them all. And we've competed well against a lot of them and beaten some of them. And to go to postseason now for our fourth straight year and have a chance to win our third of four bowl games says a lot. And that's what we're going to try to do, is get this team ready, go get a December or January bowl win.
Well, you took a step this year, and I know you're interested in more steps, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we're 8 points away from playing tonight, you know, so that's the hard part of it. You wish you were down there, but you know you got work to do to get there still.
And your favorite player is lighting it up here while you're on the air.
My man, Torrin.
He wants to have you on broadcast more often.
That's right. My man.
Well, not only will he be Dave Doran's favorite player, he might be Kevin Keats's favorite player once he finds out what this well, it also speaks to the other thing I know that exists here at NC State, and the camaraderie among coaches and the coaching staffs is really good here.
It is. You know, I've got a great relationship with Wes Moore and Elliot Avent. Yeah. They're two of my good friends, and I'm getting to know Coach Keats. He's been great since he arrived, and, you know, Derek Wittenberg's around. You get to see him all the time, and, you know, Coach Pop over in wrestling, I think, you know, all those guys, you know, they're fun to be around. They're good people.
Congratulations on your new deal, your great season. Best to your family and best in the postseason.
Thanks for having me, guys. Go Pack.
All right. Dave Doran with us. Stay tuned. Wolfpack in front 23.
ACC College Basketball is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the ACC. GEICO. New York Life. And Bojangles.
Well, the statue of Everett Case, of course, who brought the passion for college basketball to Tobacco Road when he came to North Carolina State as their head coach. 23-point lead for the Pack as we rejoin you from PNC Arena in Raleigh, where, by the way, the Hurricanes host the Florida Panthers in this facility tonight. Face-off at 7 o'clock, Mike. So kudos to the folks at PNC Arena for being able to get their business taken care of.
And, Wes, I've been told, and I'd love to see a time-lapse photography of the breakdown and then the, you know, refilling. Of course, the ice is underneath the surface. But I've been told that this crew can get this all together in an hour and a half.
That's awesome. Well, I've seen the Carrier Dome flip from football to basketball or basketball to football. There's your 7, a presence at the rim, and big fellow with a handle as he comes front court. And there's a nice pass. Bats and a foul on Raynor Powell.
Yeah, so
going to the hoop.
For after the final whistle, if you feel your seat being pulled out from underneath you, you know what it's all about.
Well, Janae Raynor Powell picks up the personal. And the team foul is number 1 on South Carolina State here in the second half, as Omer Yurtseven will go to the free throw line. He's only 58%. And here's the front end of the 2 that's down for the road. It's the only thing I can find wrong with his early line, by the way, is his free throw percentage.
Which is unusual, Wes, because he's got a very nice shooting stroke. You just got to think that it's a matter maybe of reps at this point, or lack of reps, or lack, you know, just lack of confidence in general.
Mm-hmm.
Although he does average just over 3 free throw attempts a game.
15 for him. And here is Dante Wright turning it over in transition. About 6 minutes gone now, second half.
Another illustration of that pursuit from behind that NC State puts out there.
And that is Freeman. Another one. 3 threes now for Al Freeman. And he's got 13.
And a turnover in the backcourt on South Carolina State. The Baylor grad transfer starting to warm up here a little bit in half two.
Well, you look at NC State, they've got two primary three-point shooters, and Freeman and Sam Hunt. Hunt coming off the bench, but imagine putting those two on the floor together and what kind of separation and spreading you can cause defensively. Then you throw your seven in there who's shown the ability to knock down the three.
State now 10 of 11 from the floor in the second half as Torin Doran has got 8.5 and now has his first double-figure game in his last five.
The Dave Dorn effect.
Yeah. Wait till Kevin Keats here is the football coach's favorite player went off while he was talking to us here. NC State's pushed the lead to 29. Dante Wright, a step back three. Well done by the Bulldogs' leading scorer. He's got now 9 in the ball game on his third triple of the afternoon.
Yeah, they just, after going through everything that transpired in that first half, they've settled in and played with a lot more purpose and confidence in the second half.
Rip 7 continues to be flawless from the floor, Mike.
Well, he's got Dante Wright at 5'10", guarding him basically inside.
8 of 9 from the floor, and Raynard Powell can't finish. State turns the floor over quickly. Oh, Doran! Wow.
That was with three guys back, too.
Rimmed out at the South Carolina State end, and a reach-in foul going to be whistled on Dante Wright. How about another look of Torin Doran?
Yeah, the ability to change ends and not get it to a point guard. Pretty shifty move. Just, nobody, you've got to stop the advance of the dribble. He just split everyone.
First appearance of the year for Spencer Newman. So check in for Al Freeman. And you see Doran also go to the bench as well as Sam Hunt, Lenard Freeman, and LeVar Batts and Sean Kirk have also come back to the floor. State's made 9 straight from the field to push this lead now to 30. Bats in the corner. Sam Hunt to extend it. Cannot. Missed on the three. And Alex Taylor the rebound for South Carolina State. The whistle and backcourt foul on the Wolfpack. And it'll be on LeVar Batts, his third. And as we reach the 12-minute mark in the top of the hour, we welcome you to PNC Arena in Raleigh for ACC College Hoops with Mike Chiminski, West Durham, in a ball game that started just after 12 noon between South Carolina State and host NC State. And there's a hand check foul on Sam Hunt. The ball game was interrupted for about 40 minutes during the first half with just about 7 minutes gone when Redshirt senior Tyboris Solomon of South Carolina State collapsed in front of the bench. And we'll bring you up to speed on Ty Solomon and his status as well and how it impacted this game as NC State leads by 30 in Raleigh. 76-46, our score here in Raleigh. The stoppage of play for 40 minutes in the first half was because Tyboris Solomon collapsed in front of the South Carolina State bench due to the prompt work of the staff, coaching staff at South Carolina State, their athletic trainer, and the EMS and EMT people on site here at PNC Arena, affiliated with not only the arena but NC State. Solomon was able to be resuscitated and is at a local hospital with head coach Murray Garvin. Now, Coach Garvin told ESPN.com's Jeff Goodman that Ty is awake and responding, wants to tell everybody he's thankful for the prayers. Garvin has also told Goodman, now this is Murray Garvin telling Jeff Goodman, that Solomon's heart stopped and he was resuscitated by South Carolina State's athletic training personnel on the floor here at PNC Arena. That's according to Murray Garvin, the basketball coach at South Carolina State, telling ESPN.com's Jeff Goodman. So our thoughts and prayers with Ty Solomon for a full recovery, as well as the South Carolina State Ball Club, Mike, because when this occurred, they were clearly shaken, as were people in this arena.
Well, and how about the, you know, you Those are the worst thoughts that you would have as an athletic trainer. You know, you're thinking about ACLs and all that stuff. And then for him to have the presence of mind to administer CPR as the EMT was getting there, which was, you know, was quickly, you know, credit, unbelievable credit to him to react to a situation immediately.
So Rio Pitt is the associate head coach, former player at South Carolina State in Orangeburg, and longtime aide in the basketball program, who was promoted to associate head coach by Coach Garvin last offseason. And he is running the program. Coach Garvin is with Tyvore Solomon at the area hospital here in Raleigh. And those of you know, there's several hospitals in the area as LeVar Batts finishes the three-point play. He's now got five. The foul was on Rayshon Neal. We don't know specifically if it's Rex, Wake Medical Center, what have you. So I don't want to speculate. But Ty Solomon is, according to Jeff Goodman, recuperating.
Across the board, whether it's in Raleigh, Durham, or Chapel Hill, medical care outstanding.
Yep. Neal has had quite a second half here. He's now got a dozen. That's his first at 10 points in the first half when the game was resumed, and has picked up the scoring here. And Tariq Clement is also on the floor now, wearing number 12. First time we've seen him for South Carolina State after a bucket a moment ago. And Batts, an initiative off the wing, draws another foul.
We saw in the first half, Wes, it was mostly the bigs that dominated the game, and now the wing players and the guards for NC State starting to get a little bit more active. Torin Dorn has had a terrific end of the first half, beginning of the second half. Now, Batts here. It's Kevin Keith's always be his first signee here at NC State.
Well, North Carolina Player of the Year, who had originally committed to Virginia Commonwealth to play for Will Wade. And how does the coaching carousel, you were talking to Dave Dorn about silly season. Well, the coaching carousel sometimes affects things like this. Originally committed to VCU, Will Wade goes to LSU.
But at least that usually happens in the offseason. You know, the thing with me with college coaches is it happens between the end of the regular season and the bowl game, if you're fortunate enough to qualify. And that just always struck me as really odd.
And there's a foul. And I believe on Batts for a hold. Les Jones off the baseline. And that will be his fourth. So the young freshman in a little bit of foul trouble, and that'll bring Braxton Beverly back for the Wolfpack.
Well, we didn't, you know, specifically get into it, but with Coach Dorn, but sure, the Texas A&M sent several Brinks trucks to Tallahassee to escort Jimbo Fisher out.
Well, the reported number is just making him
staggering.
The second highest paid coach in college football.
And it's the largest overall deal, though, ever seen, 10 years at that number.
Right. I will say that Dave Dorn is part of a coaching renaissance, and there's a shot clock violation against South Carolina State. Mike, you go back 5 years. 2013 was Dave Dorn's first season in Raleigh. It was the first season of Dave Clawson, or I'm sorry, not Dave Clawson, because he just finished season four at Wake Forest. But you go back 5 years, you find
David Cutcliffe.
He's 10 years.
But that's when the effect of him really kind of.
You talk about the coaching renaissance. And John Swofford addressed this week. The coaching commitment made in football has been the reason this league has gained in national notoriety in the last 3 years, 4 years for sure. You go back, Dabo Swinney was named the interim coach in 2008. That was 10 years ago. He got the full-time job from Terry Don Phillips at the end of the year. Paul Johnson arrived at Georgia Tech. David Cutcliffe arrived at Duke 10 years ago. You start looking at the four hires that were made 3 years ago. Bronco Mendenhall, Dino Babers, Pat Narduzzi. Tremendous hires. Dave Clawson the year before that. Dave Dorn, part of that five-year window. Steve Adazio's in that five-year window at Boston College.
It's
changed football.
It's going to be interesting to see, especially in the Florida State situation, because that transition from Coach Bowden to that was already in place.
Yep.
Now this is going to be starting off fresh. There is no heir apparent, I wouldn't think.
That's right.
You know, you'd have more of a feel for it than I would. But
you're right.
This is going to have to be, you know.
Stan Wilcox, the athletic director.
Yep.
First big hire.
Yep.
And he's been there a few seasons in Tallahassee.
Worked as an assistant with Kevin White at Duke for a long time and then took that job.
How about our Z-Max performance play? We've seen a couple of candidates. How about Markell Johnson? Oh,
just threading the needle against that zone and free, a little pick and roll. Nice action. No help from the weak side.
Well, I couldn't be more excited for Leonard Freeman, Mike.
Yeah, and it just, you know, for your senior year, one, you hate to see anybody get hurt, but two, the most you can ask for is for them to get healthy after battling injuries.
Sean Kirk fouled on the way up. Junior from White Bull will get a chance.
I tell you what, early on we talked about in the league, one of the more fascinating stories to me is Luke May.
Yeah.
What he is doing at North Carolina, you know, and, you know, where he came from as a freshman.
Mm-hmm.
But for Leonard Freeman, and it's not easy either to be a senior and get a new head coach.
Yeah.
You know, you had Mark Gottfried, and now all of a sudden you get a new voice in there. But, you know, Kevin is so upbeat and so positive, it's hard not to like him. And you would think it's hard not to play hard for him.
Yep. Sean Kirk's first free throws of the year. And he got one of the two. Well, this league flexed its muscle a little bit this week in the ACC Big Ten Challenge, didn't it?
Yeah. That's the best record, 11-3, the best record by either conference ever in the history of that matchup.
Yep. So it'll be an interesting year in the ACC to see kind of, we talked about that theory. Here's Kennard rerouting on the dribble and draws a foul. We'll get a timeout. Well, we're getting closer and closer. Back after this. Well, Omer Yurt 7 coming off a 19-point game, 11 rebounds on Wednesday night against Penn State. Had skipped a beat, G-Man.
No, it's nice to see a guy string games like that together. This is the time of the year when you really build your confidence. Last year really set back by missing those first 9 games, Wes. I really think it stunted his development a little bit, having to go right into ACC play. But he's playing very confidently right now, 8 or 9 shooting. He's headed toward, we doubt he'll see the court for the rest of the game, but could have easily had his second consecutive double-double.
Well, and he's on our party star to watch as the free throws go down for Bottenberg. It's his first attempt of the day. And it's a 31-point game. And the second one good.
And Kennard stepping up to the line, 74%.
Markell Johnson. ...79% from NC State from the floor in the second half. Beverly trying to add to it. That'll take it down a point or two. And a reach in on Sean Kirk. With 7:28 to play. And don't forget ACC basketball brought to you by Tire Pros. Ask the participating Tire Pros of the Carolinas dealer how you can save $25 on your next tire purchase. Second foul of the ball game on Kirk. It's 3 on the pack. Raynor Powell looking inside. Kennard had it batted away. Leonard Freeman. Look ahead. Here's Kirk. Catch, layup.
Wes, we talked, you know, talking about teaching points. NC State, 10 turnovers in half. Only 4 to this point in this game. That was a beautiful look ahead.
Yep. Well, I'm sure there's something competitive about turnovers for Kevin Keats. It's a fascinating practice, Mike, to watch because everything is competitive. There's a standard to reach in every drill, and that's one of the things he did at UNC Wilmington that, my goodness, got him 72 wins in 3 years.
And you know what, Wes? When you do it that way, you don't have to practice for 3 hours.
Yeah.
You can get a lot done in an hour and a half. It was interesting reading some of the players' quotes when he first got here, and they thought they were at a track practice instead of a basketball practice. Because when you lose, you run.
Yeah, Leonard Freeman's great line, right? time to go to the basketball court for track practice. Well, even through some of the drills we saw yesterday. There's a standard. When the standard's not met, there's a consequence for it. And you know what? I respect the culture building as much as I do the basketball building a little bit, because we all know this. And look, Sean Kirk misses here, and South Carolina State the rebound. Part of what NC State lacked was not basketball issues, Mike. It was culture issues in cases, right?
Yep, absolutely. And, you know, I guess the only shame of it is that Braxton Beverly wasn't able to take part in a lot of that because of the NCAA.
Yeah.
But, you know, other than that, it was a huge opportunity this summer and early on for Kevin Keats to really get this group together quickly.
Markel Johnson can't finish. Leonard Freeman draws the foul from Battenberg. And that's four on Battenberg. And 45-year-old Kevin Keats, native of Lynchburg, Virginia, knows very well what he's done by taking a job in the Atlantic Coast Conference. You see the impressive record at North Carolina Wilmington, and of course was an assistant at Louisville. He's got a ring from that 2013 national title at the Georgia Dome in Atlanta when they beat Michigan.
And I gotta imagine too, Wes, that he's gonna have maybe an attitude of like Jim Valvano had, of coming into a really tough neighborhood, you know, when you've got the two programs right down the road, and he's going to take the challenge on, I believe.
Absolutely. And he's got the kind of style that obviously influenced by Rick Pitino and his tenure at Louisville, but also because of his work in A.W. Hamilton, who started his career at Wake Forest before finishing at Marshall, was with him at Hargrave, and later became the head coach at Hargrave, and there's A.W.
So I would think that would be a fertile start of a recruiting ground for him.
Yeah, it's interesting. The staff has got some very interesting ACC ties to it. There's Markel Johnson off the South Carolina State miss as we go under 6 minutes here in Raleigh this afternoon. LeVar bats three.
Do you think James Johnson has a handle on the league?
Well,
he's been in a few programs.
Well, that is, to me, one of the more interesting hires. And I'll tell you, here's Kirk. Look out. Sean Kirk's calling card is normally a dunk. And there it is. Nice loop. Markel Johnson teed him up. State by 32, headed to 100. NC State's lead is 32, and the latest is Markel Johnson to Sean Kirk, and that's our Bass Pro Shots in the net this afternoon, G-Man.
Right, we talked about him. He has not played very much in this season. DNP in 6 out of 8 games, so this, you know what, Wes? I never believe in the term garbage time,
right?
There's always something to be learned, you know, especially for guys who haven't had a lot of court time, to get out there, perform, play well. You know, for Bats, this is every game's going to be a learning situation for him. So I hate to degrade, you know, just because of the score of the game.
Right. NC State has definitely had some teaching points here this afternoon both ways. Wolfpack's not a terribly deep basketball team, Mike. Number one, that means they got to be in great shape too.
Yeah, and then they've had, like a lot of teams around the, you know, around the league, have had a really jam-packed November. But now, including this game, play 3 games in the next 2 weeks. Now they've got exams coming up on Monday,
right?
So it's an equally stressful time.
Well, they only have 3 games the next 2 weeks. In fact, we're going to see the back end here in 2 weeks against West Miller and UNCG.
But maybe nobody benefits more than the way you get the practice time with your team, you know, outside of once you get past exams.
Right.
But, you know, you hope Malik Abu continues to get healthy and can maybe get on the court.
Kirk off the baseline.
I would think they'd like to get him some action in non-conference before they get into conference play.
Yeah, they open at Clemson on the 30th. Boy, Brad Brownell's team, a nice win the other night in Columbus, Mike, and there is Dorn at the other end.
Wes, 10 of the teams in the league are undefeated or have one loss at this point. So a very, and I think in a year when a lot of people thought that this was going to be a really top-heavy conference with, you know, really a lot of question marks, this team included in the middle of it.
Yep. I don't know how you felt about it. it was almost impossible to do the preseason poll.
No, Duke was prohibitively above others, but even North Carolina in transition, what they lost,
Syracuse.
Yep.
Who knows? State could be in the mix up 30 here today.
ACC College Basketball is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the ACC, Food Lion and Toyota.
Well, NC State by 30 under 4 minutes to go, and it's been Torin Dorn, Lenard Freeman, and Omer Yurtseven that have helped the Wolfpack to this advantage. Here's our news and notes. And, Mike, I want you to go back to what you were talking about a moment ago. Easy to pick Duke one, and after that,
yep.
look at the top 25.
But again, you look at Notre Dame. Mike Bray just keeps on churning out teams after team. Yeah. They got handled by Michigan State. Miami, the same way. Jim Larrañaga and, Leonard Hamilton, Florida State. Tony Bennett, what he's built. Well, how about this game? You got Virginia, Wisconsin in the Big Ten Challenge.
Rock fight.
There were 57 possessions total.
In the game?
In the game.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I hope they serve five-hour energies before game.
Nice of you to help yourself with the head to the league. Along the baseline goes Jones for the layup.
Well, you know what? I thought the fan base here was terrific today.
Yeah.
And how they reacted to that, incredible situation with Ty Solomon.
Yeah.
And then how they reacted when that team came out of the locker room, and how they reacted when the coaches came out.
Yeah.
And, I'm just glad now that in the last 5, 6, 7 minutes they've been able to enjoy a basketball game.
Yeah, out of the corner, J.J. Richardson, the miss. Ty Solomon collapsed in front of the bench with 13 minutes to go in the first half. We had a 40-minute stoppage while the South Carolina State and NC State training staffs, the medical personnel, the EMT, EMS folks here at PNC Arena, and a foul on the drive-by against Sam Hunt.
These two teams bonded by the events of today, and you saw immediately that Sam Hunt went over to to pick Richardson up off the floor.
Yep.
And great show of sportsmanship there. But
Sam Hunt's a grad transfer from North Carolina A&T, so this is not his first meeting with South Carolina State.
No, and he's also in the non-conference playing extremely well in the MEAC. I guess somebody gets a free something if they hit 100.
Yep.
I'm just guessing.
I think that's correct. Two misses in a row. It's a free throw situation. Under four free throws. They got to miss both to get something. So they got the free throws on the miss by Richardson.
Maybe we can double down on 100.
Hey, as I learned by getting two freshmen into college, kids will do strange things for free food. Johnson fouled on the drive with 2:16 to play. And so, Ian Kennard's third.
I always laugh at those commercials for the restaurant that say kids eat free.
Yeah.
Kids always eat free. My son never paid for anything,
Come on, Noah.
Slap some leather.
Here's Markel Johnson. Johnson came into the ballgame kind of a struggle assist to turnover ratio. And here today, Markel has had 12 assists and 3 turnovers. The last 3 games, 7 assists, 11 turnovers. But in that same 3-game span, 7 steals, Mike.
Yep.
And I'm going to ask you, write this down somewhere. Early December, Markel Johnson could be the steals leader in the ACC.
Second right now.
Early returns, right?
Yeah.
Early returns, that could be your ACC steals leader at the end. The way they play, the style, the number of minutes, just kind of foreshadowing a little prognostication there for you.
Well, you got to think that last year playing against Dennis Smith in practice helped him.
Oh, yeah.
It may not have helped his, court time.
Yep. By the way, the 11 assists was his previous career high. Now he's got 12. That's a new career high for Markel Johnson. Final 2 minutes here in Raleigh today. NC State won the previous two meetings with South Carolina State. By the way, played on in December of 2007, December of 1997, and now here today in December of 2017. Every 10 years, seemingly, the Pack and Bulldogs get together. And Richardson a three. Alex Taylor to follow. His first point.
Black Taylor, number 33.
And Richmond Wake Forest, game two of our two-game set here today. 4 o'clock start time at the Joel Coliseum. Tom Wormy and Damian Fishback standing by to have a look at Danny Manning and Chris Mooney's respective clubs. Deacons are an interesting study of a team that's, boy, seen its roster really kind of take a different shape with the early departure of John Collins and then the loss of Dinos Mitoglou in late July to a pro contract in his native Greece.
Yeah, and just a lot to overcome under 500 at this point.
Yeah.
But, you know, you lose that talent.
Here's a look at the upcoming slate for NC State. The Kangaroos of Missouri, Kansas City will be here next. Actually, that's at Reynolds Coliseum, Mike.
I love those games, the tradition games over there.
Every year. Reynolds,
I think they've done a magnificent job of turning that into an arena / Hall of Fame.
Yep.
I agree. You know, I've done that game a couple times, and always take a couple hours just to walk through and see everything.
Yeah. A little friendlier venue for you now, isn't it?
I got me getting dunked down by Kenny Carr, you know, me getting dunked down by Hawkeye Whitney.
You
know,
you mean Clyde laid it up on you in there, too, huh?
Yeah, Clyde Austin.
Yeah, yeah. Kind of got the full service over there at Reynolds, didn't you? Oh, man. Well, Kevin Keats is going to be 7-2, and he'll get a week before Missouri-Kansas City's here, and then another week before we'll see them again, Mike, against North Carolina Greensboro.
Pales in comparison to what happened earlier, and our best and prayers to Ty Solomon and
absolutely
and the whole South Carolina State family and his family.
Yep.
Hope for all the best.
Yep, Ty Solomon is at a local hospital recuperating. Murray Garvin telling Jeff Goodman he was resuscitated on the floor, but appears to be on the mend, and that's great news for everybody. But the Bulldogs and Wolfpack square off here, and NC State a winner. 103-71. How about the combination of Dorn, Freeman, and your seven going 22 of 23 from the floor for 50 points? Pretty strong effort, G-Man.
No, absolutely. And they set the tone early going inside, using the size, and then it was the wing players at the end.
For Casey Carter, our producer, Ken Neal, our director, Mike Jaminski, West Durham from Raleigh on a winning Saturday for the Wolfpack. So long.